Hey guys, hope you're all fine. Welcome. In this tutorial, I'm going to share how you can create interior for building in three different ways. In the first method, you will learn how you can create a simple interior by baking textures and using the mesh inside of the building. Then in second method, I will share a material which work as a cube map and will use it for faking the interiors. The third method is more advanced one, in which you will learn how you can use a mesh and use them as parallax inside the cube map. So let's get started. So before making interior, first select two corner window panels and copy them, and then add a new scene to your project and paste two copied windows in this new scene. Then select the window and add 3D cursor to the selected. Now you will need to add cube to the scene and move it behind the window mesh. Then select the vertex inside the snap option and snap it behind and closer to the window. Make sure to match the length and width of the cube to the size of the window panel. Then in edit mode, delete the front side of the mesh and then delete or hide window. It's better to delete them because it will help later when I will be baking textures for the interior. Now in edit mode, delete the left face of the cube and then add an edge loop to the center of the mesh and slide it down slightly. Then select the two upper faces of the wall, then add material slot. Then click on add new to add new material to it and assign this material to the mesh. Then select the bottom faces of the wall with the roof and do the same. You will need to repeat it for the floor. In the floor material, add checkered node inside the node editor, then increase the dark value inside the color 2 of the checkered node. Then plug that into the base color. You can play with the scale value to increase or decrease the scale of the texture. Then select the upper two faces of the wall and add checkered texture node inside of it. And do the same as I did for the floor material. After that, add Voronoi texture, then plug its distance to the vector of the checkered node. You can decrease randomness value to have that tileable design for the mesh, then change the value of checkered to create more variation of the design. Also, you can change the F1 option to F2 to any other option available to get even more variation. Increase randomness value if you don't want texture to be tileable. Play with these settings to get your desired results. After that, select the bottom faces of the wall with the roof and give slightly brown color to it. You can add whatever you want for the texture of the room. I'm just demonstrating how you can use these texture from these materials to bake them later. Now inside the UV editor, add a texture to it and change the generating type to color grade. Then select the left side wall and UV unwrap it. Then in UV editor, select scale inside of the snap tool. After that, choose 2D cursor for the pivot point. Then select the bottom left vertex and add 2D cursor to it. Then press A to select this UV and scale it down so that its top right corner lies in the center of the grid. Then I'm going to rotate it on 90 degrees so that bottom part faces towards the center and position it to cover the grid. Do the same to the other side of the wall, unwrap it, scale it down and move it to the top right of the UV grid. Again, do the exact same thing to the roof of the cube and move it to the bottom right side of the UV grid. Now select the floor of the cube and repeat the previous step again, but for the floor you will need to unwrap it and move its UV to the top left side of the UV grid. When you are done with the UVs, add image texture to its material. Then click on the new and name it room. You can give 1K, 2K or 4K dimension for the UVs. Then you will need to copy paste this image texture node inside every material that is applied to this mesh. The reason is it needs to be inside every material for baking material texture. Now we just need to add light for the room. Press Shift A and select the area light from the light tab. Also make sure to add zero value for the background strand so that it does not influence while you are baking light. Then select the light and give it orange red color to give warm colors to it. And then scale down the area light and position it closer to the wall. Then add 3D cursor to the area light and add a plane to the scene as a source light mesh and scale it down to the size of the light and move it behind the area light. Then add emissive shader to the plane and give similar colors to the mesh and increase its strength value to brighten it up. Then duplicate both light and mesh to the other side of the wall. Then duplicate it again to the corner of the mesh. To check it out, change the render engine to cycles and render it inside the 3D viewport to preview it. After that, select the mesh and in edit mode, select all and recalculate normals and under the dialog box, check inside. If you don't do this, you will not be able to bake the textures. I'm changing the device from CPU to GPU compute to decrease the baking time. You can also increase the render samples to get more clear image for the baking. And then don't forget to select room image texture node inside every material. Otherwise, you will not be able to bake different textures from different materials. In the end, just go to the scene tab and under bake tab, click bake with the default setting, which will be combined. While baking, I'm changing the texture to room texture inside UV editor to see the end results. As you can see, it has baked the texture inside the UV editor. Now duplicate this room mesh and remove all material from it and add new material to it. Then add image texture and select baked room texture for it. Then plug that into the base color and emissive color. Now change it to developer mode and duplicate the instance of the mesh one more time and mirror it to flip it and snap it to connect with the other mesh. Now in edit mode, you can duplicate left side of the wall and position it on the right side. Don't forget to save this texture for this room so later you can use it for many other methods. After that, just copy these two rooms and go back to your original scene and paste these meshes. Then move these meshes closer to the window that you want to be used for showing interiors. Then move these interior inside of the selected windows and use the snap tool to snap them to the edges of the window. Then select these window panel and duplicate them and move them slightly down to get rid of the instance mesh. Then delete the instance window panels and move these two back to their places. Now select both of them and in edit mode select the glass faces and hide them. Then select the faces of the window blinds and delete them. Now you will be able to see the interior from outside of the building. This technique is one of the easiest and one of the simplest way to make interior for a building in which you can add many more baked meshes inside it to make it even more detailed. Or you can also use the texture on the wall for doors, cabinets and much more stuff in it. For the cube map, I'm using Blender file in which the shader is created by a Blender user named Magryllia. I will link his Twitter account in my description box so that you can check out his work. These walls which you can see inside of the plane are because of this shader. By default, it's using the Blender color grid, but you can give any texture to these walls. I have slightly updated this shader by using the frame so that it will be easy for you to later use this shader for your own projects. But if you want to pan or change location of the texture inside the shader, you can use wall texture panner scaler and change or play with its value to pan the top bottom planes. Same goes for the left right plane and for the front one as well. You can also push the wall by using these pusher values for each and every plane of the wall. You can increase or decrease the value to change the position of the wall inside the shader. Now, if you want to have any other texture for the wall plane, you just need to use the default frame and change its texture. I will be using this texture that I have baked before, as its UV matches exactly the texture UV position of the shader. Just click on the cross button inside the image texture to remove the texture and open the baked texture inside of this node, and you will be able to see the baked texture projecting on the walls. After that, all you need to do is append this plane inside of your project. If you want to know how to append any mesh to a project, click on the above link to know how you can do that. If you already have the plane in your scene, just copy paste it and move it closer to the window. You can use the snap tool to snap it to the position of the window panel. Move it inside till it covers the top window shade inside of the glass plane. After that, add an edge loop horizontally to this plane and slide it according to the midpoint of the window frame. And select the lower face. And press Y to separate it and move it inside till the borders of the lower frame shows off. And that's how you can use the cube map shader to fake the interiors by giving depth to a single plane. Now you can duplicate the instance of the plane and snap it and move it to any other window panel to show the interior of a building. Remember, this method is limited to Blender only, as for gaming engines. The procedure for creating cube map is different, but you can use it and fake the interior if you are using Blender for render. For the parallax effect, you will need to bake the height map, and for such tasks, if you download the files from Magryllia Twitter account, it comes with the Z project file in which you can render out the height map. And don't worry, I will provide you all the project files that I have updated, so make sure to look into the comments or description box. To create height map, all you need to know is that the meshes you want to be used should be within the distance from the camera till the end point of the Suzanne mesh. So whatever you place inside of this project, just make sure you only use the distance between the camera and the back end of the Suzanne model. I have already placed a pot and curtain within the distance. I wanted them to be closer to the window, so I have placed them as much as closer to the camera. Also, make sure that the things you are positioning are closer to the camera should be visible from outside of the window, so you will need to add the window panel and fix it inside of the camera. You just need to make sure you are in Cycles engine and delete the window and the Suzanne model and click on render image to get the height map. After that, save the image and name it Z depth. Then close this window. After that, you can also render out the albedo and the normal map by using the workbench render. Also, make sure if you are rendering normal or any map except the height map, don't forget to plug the render layer to the composite inside the compositing tab. Then hit render to render out and save images after rendering them. This is the project file of Parallax map, which includes cube map, but I have updated this material so that it will be easy for you to use it in your projects. To have parallax effect, all you need to do is add the Z depth image texture inside of this node. Press tab while you select it to get into this node, then add the Z depth texture inside of the image texture. Then hit tab again to get out of this node. Then increase the positive value slightly and you will see the meshes we baked are moving inside of the cube map. Then add normal map texture inside of the normal to add shading to the model. You can also add any map for the parallax mesh. I will be providing you the project files for the cube map and Parallax. So don't forget to check out the description box or the comment box. And that's pretty much about it. Hope you guys like it. If you like my tutorial, then subscribe and support me on Patreon, where you will be able to get the project files that I have used in my tutorial. Thanks for watching.